Welcome back to Allison Customs Project Car TV. I'm Jeff Allison, and thank you for watching. Hey, so I'm back on the dash, and I showed you some parts in what I've got, and the things that, I guess there's two items that I know for sure their location, and that's going to be this rectangle for the stereo and where the tack is. And what they are set at is center of the dash for the tack, top to bottom, center up top to bottom for the stereo. Then when I was laying everything out, what I decided is I didn't want as big a gap here, mostly because I need the space for the boost and the fuel pressure gauges. So I'm going to squeeze these in. I want them same on both sides, so I'm going to move them from where they are in 3/8 of an inch, which is about to where the end of the arrow is there. I need, like I said, I need room over here, so I'm going to move this AC vent a half inch closer to the edge. If I move that one, I need to move this one, so that one goes over a half inch closer. And then that will allow me the space for the boost and the fuel pressure, get my speedo and my 4-in-1 here. Plus, I still have to, the original dash, there's not, the latch isn't in the door. The latch is actually for the door, is actually right up here. So I've got to kind of re-engineer that process of closing this glove box door. Other than that, the layout is essentially what we're going to use. Just got to tweak everything over. So the decision was made to leave the bottom of the panel flush to the curve here. And I go back and forth with what I like, and I like old muscle cars, and I like stuff to look like the old muscle car might have come from the factory that way. The owner wants an old muscle car that looks very modern, so having little details like that where something is inset kind of brings back that old feel, and that's not what he's after. What he's after is as modern a looking 66 Chevelle as we can get. So you go look at a new car and everything is smooth and rolled and ties together. So that's the way we're going. Now, that said, I've still got the tape in there. Made my life easier because I don't have to cut tack welds and move stuff. But that's what the customer wants. That's what they're going to get. What we're going to do now, so I'm going to go ahead and the tack is staying in place. The double din stereo stays in place. So what I'm going to do is use my tape, cover up some of the things that are moving, get them redrawn in, get some center holes punched and drilled, and corner holes on all the rectangles. That way I can take the tape off, do my finished welding. I don't have to do my layout again. Everything is set to go in place. Right now, all I'm going to do is start covering up some of the lines that I don't need.
You know, like we were talking about with the Dykem earlier, I'm a pretty Harry Potter fan, but I keep thinking of that Dykem or whatever they called the headdress in Harry Potter. Anyway. You got kids, you know what I'm talking about, because you probably watched or listened to Harry Potter. If you don't, just ignore me. I'm just taping. But anyway, the blue dye that you can use for sheet metal or steel or whatever. It's used a lot in the machining processes of steel for marking. I found some spray-on version, so in the future, rather than having to try and tape all this off, I could use the dye. And then when you find that you didn't like the way something laid out, you just either respray it or use the little dauber brush and brush it back on, brush on new stuff over your scratches and scratch again. And it's nice because you don't need to scratch very deep or anything to cover it up, or to make the lines. You're not trying to actually scratch into the metal, you're just scratching some of that blue dye off.
I don't really remember exactly where I left off. Anyway, I got this panel welded in. I ended up getting a little bit of warpage in it. It's not too bad. I'll probably be able to shrink most of it out. And then whatever's left is probably under a, certainly under an eighth of an inch, but probably under a 16th even. And as long as that's the case, be able to body work it, never be able to see it again. So what I'm going to do right now is go ahead and make panel here. So I just took a piece of cardboard, got pretty close to the right width, and cut that out. Now this has rounded corners, plus it has a bend, and it's not a real tight bend, but it's got a bend there and then rounded corners at the bottom. So one of the necessities here is to go ahead and try and estimate that curve. And remember, you want your sheet metal just slightly smaller than the hole you're working with. If you're going to MIG weld it, about the thickness of your wire. So I'm using 22 gauge or 0.022 wire. They're a little tight, so made mine a little more of a turn than they needed to be. But I'm just going to shorten the paper here just a little bit. I think that's going to pull them up in there pretty well. Yeah. I'll make myself a little note to leave just a little bit in the corners when I transfer it over to metal. So then the next thing is we want to find about where that bend is going to be. What I'm going to do that is try and transfer this line where the top of this is going to be, and then rather than trying to hold it over that hole, all I got to do is move it over here.
Put the bend in it. I'm going to mark the peak of the bend. I'm just kind of doing that by feel. If you don't get that mark, then when you go to transfer the sheet metal, it'll be a little more difficult to try and find it. My paper's a little long, so it's catching on the bottom.
And then looks like we got plenty of paper, so I'm going to kind of do the same thing. I'm going to transfer this line. I'll lay this on here. We can see it. Come this way with it. Everything looks good there. A little further.
Looks good there. Transfer it there. We got this one there, so.
Looks about right. So now we're going to take this, transfer it to a piece of sheet metal. And I have some laying around from when I was working on the other parts.
I'm going to flip it over. Use those same two corners for the top. We're going to call this up. And we want to transfer our bend lines.
And we'll get it cut out. We'll put that roll in it. And then see if we can't get it tack welded in. Panel's cut. Need to shape the corners just slightly, just dead on the right width. So we'll shape those corners real quick.
Those look real good. These two.
Everything looks good, so I'm going to come in, put that bend on there. A couple different ways to try and do it. I don't need a lot of bend, but you want it preformed. You don't want to just try and get it on here and then try and form it as you weld it, and the metal gets a little more pliable, but you won't get a straight line across that bend. So what I want to do is find something of, you know, close to this radius as far as a piece of tubing. I'm going to guess that's pretty close, and I'm going to clamp that to that bar, and then I'm going to bend it over the bar. Now you can see, got a little bit of bend in there, and I probably don't have enough, but it's easier to go a little bit at a time than it is to try and take some out. There you go, a little bit more bend. I would say that is just about dead on. It's slightly too long, and it fits better from the bottom up than it does, like, fit. If I fit the top edge, my bend is too low. So my bottom edge and my bend is in the right place, so I'm going to take a little bit off the top, and we're talking, oh, maybe a 16th to, I don't think it's quite a full 1/8 of an inch. Take your time here, because if you don't like how that panel fits when you're trying to get it in there just forming it or just fitting it, you won't like it when you've got it welded, and then you'll be cutting it all out. And just like the dash panel or anything else, you just take your time, you'll get it the way you're happy with it. I'm happy with that. Now, you have seen me use them many, many times. We're going to use a couple magnets to hold this thing in place. So when we're done, we want it flush with these outside panels. There we go. That looks good. Let's get a couple tack welds on there. Remember, we're trying to tack weld this. If we go to welding on it with a lot of heat, we'll have this little panel warped. And it's one thing to try and pull some warps out of a big panel where you can chase them a little bit, but this one, it'd just be ruined. We'd use our pattern to make a new one, but it's just that much more work you got to do. So take the time, move around a little bit, and just get some tack welds on it. All we want to do is hold it in place. So on this side, it's laying nice and flat. This side, it curled in just a little bit. So we're going to try and tweak that out just a little bit. Better if I use a welder. There we go. We're going to get one tack weld on this corner. Now the whole thing is laying nice and flush again. Get a weld out here. And one out towards the middle. And that's it. We're going to let that cool. Any imperfections anywhere else, when we come out with the bodywork, we'll skim coat that. You'll never see them. You see over here, I filled some other holes. I've got a few more to fill. Now I've got some backing back there, and I don't want to weld to my jig. So I'll fill those after, but the only two we're going to really need are these two for the column cover, and we're going to fill this hole because it was for a switch. We're going to be making, I think we're going to make some kind of little pod over here to catch a couple of switches, and so it'll come off this side and just kind of come out vertical, well, what would be vertical in the dash. It'll come down like this, and then it'll be boxed in on three sides. Next up, we're going to fill this one, and then we need to get the glove box mounted and make some switch holes, make the holes for the key lock. So we either got to redo it in the dash panel or figure out a way to change it over to be through the glove box door. Reach in behind here, lay a piece of paper in there, trace it out. So Let me find a piece of cardstock and we'll get started on that. This is a little big. So there we go. All right, we're going to mark this for up, cut this out, and we'll make a piece of steel out of it. All right. Is a piece of metal, so a piece of scrap from when I was making one of these panels for the dash. So we got a straight edge along the bottom and a straight edge on one corner, one end. So we're just going to trace the corner. It needs to get cut off. Up again, cut this out, clean up to the edge of the black there. It's a little bit long. And I mean very little. Right here on this end, got just a little bit of height there. I can actually see it right there in the edge of it. This area right here is rolled in just a little bit. And it could be from the welding on it, or it could be that it's just that shape originally, but we're going to flatten it out a little bit. Close. Got a high spot right here. And I just have a low spot right there in this other corner. That's going to work. Get a couple magnets to hold this in place. We'll put a couple tack welds on this corner and we'll kind of lay it in a little bit easier. I've got is just that little bit of heat has made this area right here tighten up just a tiny bit. What I'm using is about a 120 grit. See if that'll clean out in there just a little bit. Got it flush again. We'll put a couple more tack welds in. Bring the center of this up just a hair. Put another round of welds on the dash. Few welds to the back side of this, because the more of it that I can weld on the back side, the less grinding I have to do on the face, the easier it is to make everything finish out. So right there I put a little too much heat in there and I burned through. So the thing you want to do is jump right on it and start trying to fill that hole, but what you'll end up doing is putting so much heat in this area that you'll start warping this metal. Even the old stuff that's fairly thick will start to warp. So my recommendation is stay off of it, let it cool off, and come back and hit it again in a little while. So we'll come back again and let this cool off completely. We'll come back and stitch weld some more of the tacks together, put some more in here, and we'll get the face on this other one where we've got all this extra metal anyway. And slowly but surely keep welding on it until this thing is all done.
Thanks for watching Allison Customs Project Car TV. Like us on Facebook and check us out at AllisonCustomsOnline.com.